We bless your name, O Lord, for sending your own incarnate Son to become part of a family, so that as he lived his life, he would experience its worries and its joys. We ask you, Lord, to protect and watch over this family, so that in the strength of your grace, its members may enjoy prosperity, possess the priceless gift of your peace, and as the church alive and well, bear witness in the world to your glory. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord spoke to Nathan and said,
Go, tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people, Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people, Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old. Since the time I first appointed judges over my people, Israel, I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise you up, your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, To him who can strengthen you, according to my gospel, and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery, kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings, and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations, to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May be done to me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Promises, promises. We know that we are very disappointed and sometimes cynical when people make promises and they break them. And that happens all the time. You know, it happens in families, and that causes great disappointment. It happens in politics very often, and that causes great cynicism. It happens sometimes in the church, and that can cause great scandal. We hope and expect that promises made will be promises fulfilled. Now, God made a promise to David. He promised that he would build a house for David. David wanted to, of course, build a great temple for him. David wasn't to do that. It was his son Solomon who did that. The Lord at that time said, no, I am going to build a house for you. And he didn't mean a house of wood or stone, because David had a royal palace already. He meant a dynasty. This promise that he made, that David became the great one who loved the Lord very much, would sit on his royal throne forever, succeeded by his descendants forever. Well, that promise was fulfilled for a century or two, until the kings became very unfaithful, and the faith of the people unraveled and disintegrated, and they turned to other gods, and they were finally conquered by the Babylonians and led away in captivity. So that was the end of the kingdom of Israel. It seemed that God had forgotten the promise. People were unfaithful, and it seemed that God just canceled the promise and said, forget about you folks, I am not fulfilling this promise. Then today we see the Virgin Mary, this young woman from a backwater town of Nazareth, being visited by an angel, the one who was to blow the trumpet to announce the end of the world, or the fulfillment of the world. And here he didn't blow a trumpet, but he certainly invaded her being by this message that he brought her, that the promise that God had made was going to be fulfilled in her son, because she was of the house of David, her husband, Joseph, whom she was betrothed, was of the house of David. And therefore, God, after a century, after a millennium, people, to bring peace to the earth, doesn't seem to be a very effective king. Because we live in a world where there is so much discord. Somebody was telling me before Mass, or the priest in Bethlehem this year, who's not going to put the baby Jesus in the manger, but on a pile of rock, to symbolize that that's the reality they're living in now, in this terrible war that they're experiencing. We drive just down the street and find many homeless people, people living in dire poverty, without the dignity that they deserve. We don't have to go far and find domestic violence. A woman was shot yesterday by her husband, killed in Pearl Ridge. We don't have to go very far to find the breaking, it seems, of this promise. And so we can become very cynical, as I think sometimes our world tends. What good is faith if there's still so much suffering? How can God be real if there is still so much discord and still so many terrible things happening in the world? And that's why it is so important for us to be here. It is so important because it is our duty and our salvation to celebrate our faith in this promise of God. That no matter how dark things may seem, we proclaim Jesus is the light. No matter how elusive peace might be, we proclaim Him the Prince of Peace. No matter how much hatred there may be in the world, we declare Him the King of Love who lives forever. And if we don't, what will happen to the world? It will totally lose hope. It will totally turn to cynicism. And so the Lord, like as He called Mary, called us to give birth to Christ, to bring Him to life, to make Him real, because He is real, and He is here, and He is with us. And we encounter the very same Jesus who was conceived in the womb of the Virgin Mary by the power of the Holy Spirit, right here in the Eucharist, when that same Holy Spirit changes bread and wine into the body and blood of Christ. And when the one who is the Son of the Most High God and the successor of David allows Himself to come into us, to be eaten by us, so that He can nourish us and strengthen us. Because He wants to rule over the world, He wants to fulfill the promise that God has made, bringing peace and joy and love to all the world. But how will He do that unless we, who are called to be His body, embody that promise and make it real in the world? And so we come together, even in the midst of all the darkness that we experience in the world, to sing, to rejoice, to give thanks, because we know that no matter how long it may take, God is always true to His promises.
begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for our sin and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we prepare our hearts for the birth of God's Son, let us address God with our needs and the needs of all, assured that nothing will be impossible for God.
For the church, that we may echo Mary's word, may be done to me according to your word, whenever we hear the Lord's voice call to us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
O leaders of nations, that they may imitate the concerns that King David showed for the heart of God in respecting God's presence in the land and in their people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For new parents and expectant parents, that they may see the presence of the Lord in the new life he has brought into the world and into their home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are traveling to visit family or friends over the holidays, that they may be kept safe from harm as they share the joy and love of the season. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For this parish community, that we may warmly welcome neighbors, occasional worshipers, and strangers to our spiritual home as we celebrate the birth of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
All the prayers that we hold in the silence of the heart. For our intentions in the book of petitions, and for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God of all, you seek a home in our hearts, the hearts we have prepared for your Son's coming. Listen to the prayers we make from the bottom of our hearts, to the one whose coming we soon will celebrate. Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Deep as night. So
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he did with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
He took the chalice, and giving it thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
The mystery of
forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Or say we have the Misa and Father is Mesa. So Misa and Mesa is then the God of Mesa, it means people. So we eat and gather together for a celebration. So thank you and God bless you.
Thank you for that. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Along with the message. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent, and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father,